Hi and assalamu alaikum to my beloved lecturer Miss Fauzia. I would like to quickly introduce myself. I am Dr. Tushahira binti Mat Zainal from KBA 2423B. Today I will be discussing about the multinational corporations. There are three key points I'll be discussing: introduction to MNC, one of the MNC companies that I would like to cover, and the risk faced by the company and how they handle it. Now that you are aware of the overview, let's begin with introduction to MNC. Multinational corporations, often known as multinational companies, are businesses that operate in more than one country besides their native country. Multinational companies have their central head office in the home country and secondary offices, facilities, factories, industries, and other such assets in other countries. It is not enough to call a company that exports its product to more than one country a multinational company. They need to maintain actual business operations in other countries and must make a foreign direct investment there. MNCs have the potential to have a significant impact on the economies of the countries in which they operate. They create jobs and add money to the local tax base. That being said, they often face critics both at home and abroad who perceive that the impact they have on these countries may do more harm than good. To be considered a multinational corporation, a company must generate at least 25% of its revenues from operations outside of its home country to be deemed a multinational corporation. So, I have done some research with regard to this topic, and I have chosen Apple as one of the MNC companies that I would like to discuss. Let's start with the background of its company. Apple Computers Inc. was founded on April 1, 1976 by college dropouts Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak, who brought with them a vision of transforming people's perceptions of computers. Jobs and Wozniak wanted to make computers small enough for people to have them in their homes or office. Simply put, they wanted a computer that was user-friendly. Steve Jobs, Steve Wozniak, and Ronald Wayne, the founders of Apple Inc., founded Apple Computer on April 1, 1976 and incorporated the firm on January 3, 1977 in Cupertino, California. Wayne then withdrew from the partnership, leaving Jobs and Wozniak as the primary co-founders of the company. After that, Apple went public on December 12, 1980 at $22 per share. For the time being, Tim Cook is the current CEO of Apple Inc. Apple Company is a multinational corporation that creates, manufactures, and sells mobile communication and media products, as well as personal computers and portable digital music players. Apple Inc. also sells third-party digital content and apps, as well as a number of related software, services, peripherals, networking solutions, and third-party digital content. The company sells products and services such as iPhone, iPad, Mac, iPod, Apple TV, a portfolio of consumer and professional software applications, the iOS and Mac OS X operating systems, iCloud, and a variety of accessory, service, and support offerings. Furthermore, the company also sells and delivers digital content and applications through online store, the iTunes Store, App Store, iBook Store, and Mac App Store. The company offers its goods all around the world through retail locations, online stores, direct sales force, third-party cellular network carriers, wholesalers, retailers, and value-added resellers. Apple has increased the number of retail outlets and geographical coverage throughout the years, with 516 stores in 25 countries globally. The Apple company has faced various risks to its performance, whether the risk is known or unknown, that can affect project or business performance. So, let's look at the risks faced by the company in the perspective of an MNC. The first one is political factor. A major political issue is the worrying trade war between the United States and China is a huge political issue that may have an influence on Apple's sales income and market share in China, posing a risk to the company's future growth. If the US tariff will increase on Chinese import into the US, then the Chinese government will also impose heavy tax on Apple products. Finding manufacturing alternative other than China will raise the cost of Apple products, resulting in a drop in global sales. Apple is the preeminent taxpayer in the world, and any political issue will influence its overall commercial performance. The apple trade may be impacted by a new government in the United States, and the global pandemic has also had an impact on political factors. If these outsourcing partners or suppliers experience severe financial problems or other disruptions in their business, the net realizable value of these assets could be negatively impacted. Next is economic factors. Uncertainty about global and regional economic situation poses a risk to Apple. Consumers and businesses may delay spending in reaction to slow global and local economic growth, tighter credit, more unemployment, financial market volatility, or other circumstances. These worldwide and regional economic conditions could have a material adverse effect on demand for Apple's products and services. Thus, due to premium pricing policy, it faces difficulties in breaking into the ASEAN market, which has higher growth rates and great prospects for a tech brand like Apple. A strong US dollar may cause exchange rates to rise, making it more expensive for Apple to conduct business in several key areas such as Europe and China. Also, due to pandemic across the world, the economies have suffered and there have been job losses across the world. Last but not least, technology factors. The company's products and services compete in highly competitive global markets that are subject to rapid technological development, and the company may be unable to compete effectively in these areas. This is pretty obvious. Personal computers, smartphones, and tablets are all massively competitive markets, and though Apple has significant market share now, it's always possible that an upstart competitor could come along and knock Apple off its perch. Any new innovative technologies will have a significant influence on Apple's financials and market share if it is unable to maintain its leadership position in technical developments. In the meantime, competitors like Samsung, Microsoft, and Huawei are thriving in making changes for technology world. Apple's competitors provide many high-value technology items at low prices, affecting the company's brand image and ultimately financial performance. For example, brands like Lenovo keep up their place in the PC business while Apple lost it. Now that we have seen the risks that faced by the company in terms of MNC, so let's examine how the company managed the risks. Let's see how Apple company managed the risks in terms of political factors. Careful planning and monitoring of political changes are required. Before expanding, Apple should have a thorough understanding of the domestic and international affairs of the country into which they are considering expanding. Apple should be aware of the country's political stability, institutional strength, religious or political conflicts, ethnic diversity, and rights of minority. The country's standing in the international arena should also be part of the consideration. This includes its relations with neighbors, border disputes, membership in international organizations, and recognition of international law. Other than that, to reduce the political risk is to purchase political risk insurance. Apple corporations may go to one of the many organizations that specialize in offering political risk insurance and obtain a policy that would compensate them in the case of a bad incident. Next is economic factors. To limit this risk, a risk of control activities combined with financial management and regulatory monitoring will be performed, such as the formation of a financial group. The financial group uses asset portfolio to make sure the risk is sustained in a predetermined extent. Creating a group of experts to monitor and forecast economic policies. Apple is a multinational company which subsidiaries are in numbers of countries where economic policies are different from US. Complying to local legislation and responding appropriately will be important. The experts will analyze and make predictions about economic policy beforehand and give suggestions to the financial group's behavior afterwards to make sure the expectations are met. Keeping close and favorable connections with outsourcing partners, vendors, and suppliers. Not only Apple will face the financial related risk, but the relevant stakeholders will also be affected simultaneously. Keeping an eye on the conditions of the three parties will help in forecasting Apple's next move. The only way for the company to cope with rapid technological changes is keep pace with advanced technologies and develop new items. To ensure that this goal is met, Apple should evaluate its research and development process. The company can first develop a monitoring plan that lists the goal and expectation. Besides that, maintain and expand their relationship with the third-party provider of programmers, software, and digital content based on this specific operating system. Moreover, monitoring competitors' technology development patterns allows Apple to plan their next step more effectively, take an eye on competitors' behavior, and evaluating the current situation of the company is useful because it gives a chance to review whether the developing strategy is appropriate and whether the company will keep its competitive condition in the future. To sum up, multinational corporations must analyze social responsibility, employee development, competitors, and customers in accordance with corporate ethics. Companies can perform successfully if they follow the cultural norms in the countries in which they operate. In addition, they should consider the regulations and ethical framework in countries where they operate. Risk management is currently one of the most important areas of management that firms are keen to focus on. Apple Inc. is one of the major American corporations, faces several market challenges that could have a significant influence on its operations. The capacity to manage these risks effectively may determine the organization's ability to survive these challenges. Going forward, Apple needs a risk management department to analyze current and future possible risks in order to formulate agile strategies to eliminate or reduce these risks. That's all from me. Thank you.